The video you have selected will contain tangents, pot shots, and exaggeration for the sake of being needlessly rude. Feel free to leave your complaints in the comments below. Thank you.
Huh. Well, that was weird. Well, as long as you're all here, Doctor Who, anyone? Hello, interwebs. It appears I'm back from the dead yet again to talk nonsense. Hope you don't mind the new look, because these sprites took forever and so you are stuck with them. Anywho, back on topic. Doctor Who, the show that has a stranglehold on my cold, dead heart, and the fandom that has my condolences for its horrible taste. Yeah, we ain't pulling any punches around, yeah. This fandom has some pretty garbage takes. From saying 10 is the best Doctor of New Who to people calling Clara interesting, one has to wonder if the fandom is fucking with me specifically, or if they immediately lose all critical thought at the sight of a hot brunette. You can decide, because I can't be bothered. After all, that ain't the topic of today. No, that would be my beloved Let's Kill Hitler, the most right-on episode of season 6, even though the Wedding River song is right there and infinitely worse. For some reason I can't comprehend, Whovians all around the world hate this fucking episode. Today I'm here to tell you why you're all wrong and stupid and stupid and wrong. Now first off, bias is on the table. This is probably my favorite episode of season 6. It's everything I love about Doctor Who all in one messy, perfect package. It's fast, has timeline shenanigans, comedy out the wazoo, and River's in it, meaning it gets bonus points right out the gate. Does it have flaws? Yes, glaringly obvious ones. But unlike other terrible episodes like Of Love and Monsters or Family of Blood, Let's Kill Hitler is actually entertaining to make up for it. But if you still aren't convinced, let's go through this a bit more thoroughly, shall we? We start the episode off immediately.
Seriously? Well, you never answer your phone.
With a joke, setting the tone right out the gate to be much more lighthearted than the previous objectively amazing episode, A Good Man Goes to War. Which, right off the bat, we have an issue. That being the tonal shift between the mid-season finale versus the mid-season opener. And, yeah, I'll admit, especially during binges of this season watching this...
I'm Melody. I'm your daughter.
Only for it immediately to be followed up by... Yeah, it's a bit jarring, but here's the thing. This is a mid-season opener, aka the start of something new. And given how depressing this half of the season could be at times, I think starting off on a lighter note is frankly rather welcome. Hell, if the Wedding River song had been, you know, good, this could have been a really cool thing, with the Doctor losing more and more hope as the season eventually progresses to him walking to his literal death. But no, Moffat decided exposition dumps about the silence and continuity jabs were far more important. This is getting depressing, let's get back to the fun episode. Oh shit. Welcome to the show, Mels, aka Melody Pond, the unnecessary twist only added because Moffat thought it would be cool. And while I don't think it was especially cool, what I do think it is harmless, ultimately. The only thing about it I don't really like is something that can be applied to half the plot points in Doctor Who, that being they're so much done with it once the initial reactions are over. Like, I don't know, man, I think it would have been cool to use the fact that Mels and River are the same for angst, comedy, anything outside of this episode. It would have been neat, but I guess that's what fanfics are for. We go through several flashbacks, getting one of my favorite Pond moments in the series.
Love to! He's gorgeous! He's my favorite guy! He's, you know, gay!
A friend.
I love this show. And then, through a pretty fun transition, cut back to the TARDIS crashing.
How is it my fault?
You said God has been working this place! You said we're in a state of temporal grace!
Oh, that was a clever lie, you idiot! Anyone can tell that was a clever lie!
Yeah, Mels, I'm with the Doctor on this one. That was a pretty obvious lie. The TARDIS finally lands and... saves Hitler? Okay, now that's just false advertising. No wonder people hate this episode so much. Anyway, then a bunch of nonsense happens that I normally fast forward through. Really, all you need to know is Hitler tries to shoot his would-be assassin and fails so miserably that Rory puts him in the timeout cupboard.
Sit still. Shut up.
This is why you're my second fave. Oh, and Mels was shot. That was probably important to mention. So we get our regeneration reveal, which, as everyone has pointed out, went on for way too damn long as Moffat jerks off to how clever he is, and then jerks off to something else as we get the best scene in the episode. Now look, before you get on my ass, just hear me out. Is this scene just Moffat drooling over River? Yes. Is it objectifying? Possibly. But I am but a floating forest gremlin, and Alex Kingston is hot. And also, Flustered 11 fuels my heart and soul. So while you are all off calling Moffat sexist, I'm busy squeeing over green overcoat jokes. If you know, you know. In other words, you're right. But also fuck you, because my ship is happening and I don't care. Anywho, after I'm done giggling over Matt's hand placement, we quickly get back to the actual plot. River decides fun time is over and actually tries a hand at her job, giving Moffat a chance to remind us he works on Sherlock. Look, as long as they aren't playing that sound from the 11th hour, I don't care.
fucking ear rape, honestly.
Anyway, we are told, because Moffat is worried we forgot in the last few weeks, that River was raised by the Silence, aka she was raised to kill the Doctor. Thanks, Moffat. I'm sure all the viewers with short-term memory loss appreciated it.
This is what they were building. My bespoke psychopath.
I'm on your sweetie.
Never mind, everything was worth it. I'm sorry, I doubted you. Speaking of that kiss, though, seems River got into the habit of drugging her lipstick early, because as she falls out the window, her future husband is falling at death's door. And yeah, I'm kind of surprised he hadn't considered that. Like, I know kissing River tends to turn your brain off, Doc. We all remember the flailing bit, but come on. After telling the Ponds to make sure their kid stays out of trouble, and this joke...
She's been brainwashed, it all makes sense to her. Plus, she's a woman. Oh, shut up, I'm dying.
How do you guys hate this episode? We get to our next scene and next nitpick, that in a post-giggle world I think is even more ridiculous than it was previously. River, after being a queen, per usual, gets blown away by several soldiers, only to hit them back harder with her leftover regeneration energy. People say this is stupid, and yes, I agree. But, one, it's not rule-breaking or anything, it's just kind of rule-bending, which is Moffat's specialty. And two, Bi-Generation exists and is way dumber than this stunt could ever hope to be. And that was under RTD, so I don't want to hear shit about this ever again, frankly. We've now very clearly established that rules and lore don't matter in Modern Who, thanks Chibnall, so I don't see why you're all gonna get all uppity about this. Moving on!
Heil! Heil!
King shit. Back to the Doctor. So, okay, time to slow down a bit. I know I've been sort of rapid-firing through this shit, but right now we're gonna pump those brakes and talk about this scene because there's just a lot to go over. This scene says a lot, not only about this situation in particular, but a lot about this Doctor as a whole. My man is on the floor dying, and yet he's still wasting time just to get the bad news from a friendly face. Eleven, this Doctor, in particular, doesn't like dwelling on the negative, or dwelling in general. He's constantly moving, for better or worse, with one notable exception, but we can talk about everything wrong with Season 7 at a later date. Right now, he's literally dying, and in excruciating pain. So how is he supposed to keep moving? Well, he tries to drown it out, give himself something positive to pay attention to so he can push forward despite the agony. And when the TARDIS gives him a series of terrible options for this, well, he gives one of my favorite lines from Eleven in his entire tenure.
Come on! There must be someone left in the universe I haven't screwed up yet.
This line for me is one of the most heartbreaking lines Matt ever delivers. Certainly more than that long-winded speech in Season 7 anyway. This line, this moment for me, hits so much harder. I could honestly praise it for hours. And maybe one day I will, but not right now.
Fish fingers and custard.
Okay, so this moment is kinda annoying to me, not because I don't like it, I think it's cute actually, but because I feel this line is hurt a lot already by it being used very badly in The Impossible Astronaut. Honestly, I could go an entire tangent on how much I hate that conversation between Amy and the Doctor in that episode, but I will restrain myself. Point is, fish fingers and custard being referenced there makes them bringing it up here again seem way more repetitive than it would have been otherwise. Like, here it's this perfect, pure, innocent, positive, silly thing, which is the entire point, if you forgot. It's just what the Doctor ordered.
Move this man!
Oi. Anyway, enough analysis, back to the nonsense. You know, if I had a nick-
Move this man!
Rude! I didn't even get to finish my joke! So Amy and Rory are taken inside the Tesselector and- Oh shit, the Tesselector! I forgot about them, didn't I? It's almost as though they're completely irrelevant outside of foreshadowing. Yeah, the Tesselector is a shape-shifting, time-traveling spaceship full of mini-vigilantes trying to punish bad people near the end of their timelines, or some nonsense like that. And they are, frankly, completely unneeded for this episode outside of exposition. They are a plot device, and a pretty boring one at that. In fact, I'm gonna say they're the only thing in this episode I actively dislike, though, to be fair to them, that's partially having to do with their role in the wedding of River Song. God, if that episode doesn't just make everything look worse in hindsight. Oh, speaking of River, how's she doing?
No! No! Get off me!
Ah, I see. Well, as if I needed more reason to hate you.
It's a truth you can't refuse! Like a suit.
What? Neil Patrick Harris was in the show? This is relevant.
Sonic Kane, are you serious?
You know, everyone talks about how corny this all is, but really, whenever I watch this scene with silly Eleven and his Sonic Kane, my mind immediately thinks of this line.
To hell with the raggedy. Time to put on a show.
The Doctor may not be completely certain he's going to die here, but there is a strong chance, and so if he's going to die, it only makes sense to put on a show, don't you think? Anyway, we get some exposition that thankfully is interrupted by jokes whenever possible, the spoonful of sugar approach, and then we get back to the actual plot. The pawns are about to die in the test selector, the Doctor is hella dying with there not being enough positive reinforcement in the universe to get his ass off the ground. Essentially, everything's going to shit, with the pawns' fate in the hands of their psycho daughter. Oh god, I wonder what will happen. Look, I never said this episode had great twists, alright? Anyway, so the Doctor is like mega dead now and asks to talk to Melody, who he tells to find River Song and tell her,
"And you are forgiven. Always and completely forgiven."
Okay, I don't know if he actually said that, but it's the most common theory. Then he finally just stops. He gone. Melody then asks who River is, and Amy, using the Teselector, shows her that River Song is her. Dun dun dun. Sorry, I've been sort of half-assing this ending, haven't I? It's just the exposition dump sort of killed my enthusiasm. Anywho, yada yada, River has a staring contest with herself, blah blah, asks if the Doctor is worth it, etc, etc.
What are you doing?
Hello, sweetie.
Okay, I'm back. Attention gained. The regeneration energy is forming a heart. I love them so much, you don't even... Anyway, so River wakes up in the hospital and it's revealed she just wasted all of her remaining regenerations, which makes me wonder just how much energy was needed to heal him. Let's see, so she regenerated twice that we know of, each Time Lord has 13, so with that logic, it took 11 regenerations to... Oh, Moffat, you cheeky bitch. Moving on, we get a reminder of an actual good catchphrase from this era.
Rule one. The Doctor lies.
Fishfingers and Custard could never. Also, look at how broody this man is. He knows that River just put him above herself again, and it's so visibly eating at him. God, Matt's acting is so great. And I'm getting distracted again. Quick, Moffat, refocus me with cuteness.
No. She won't. She will be... amazing.
Yep, now that's the good stuff.
Well, she did kill me, and then she used her remaining lives to bring me back. As first dates go, I'd say that was mixed signals.
Trying to kill your love interest is mixed signals now? God, nobody tells She-Ra fans. And with that last bit of foreshadowing, we end the episode. This episode is great. I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. And it's not just because of the shipping moments, though. That obviously helps. No, I love this episode because of how comedic it is. This episode has some of my favorite jokes in the series. It's just nothing but fun, 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 fun. Honestly, outside of people not being obsessed with Driver as I am, I feel like a big reason people aren't fond of this episode is because it's so comedic. This episode is silly and cheesy. It has Hitler being put in the timeout cupboard and Sonic Canes. It's not the serious melodrama that Whovians love so much. This isn't Dalek or Waters of Mars. It's more like The Lodger or A Christmas Carol. And for some reason, that seems like a turnoff to Who fans, which I don't really understand. I mean, who'd have thought a show about a time-traveling alien fighting screaming trash cans with laser beams would be fucking silly? Like, this episode isn't perfect, obviously. No episode is. The Teselector is boring and unnecessary. The exposition could literally be replaced with an as-you-know speech, and there are absolutely no twists that you couldn't see coming from a mile away. But saying this episode is bad because it's silly just feels like you're being the fun police. Silly isn't a critique, just like how depressing isn't a critique. It's a neutral statement. The other reason I feel like people don't like this episode, of course, is because it's fast and confusing. Now, that first one I don't understand at all because, frankly, I think Doctor Who's pacing is far too slow the majority of the time, especially back during Russell's era. This episode being as fast as it is a plus for me all the way. The confusing complaint, though, well, now that one just seems unfair. The reason this episode is considered confusing is because of the wedding of River Song. And no, I'm not just saying that because I like this episode and hate that one. In case you forgot, that was the episode that was meant to tie up all the loose ends of River's story, not this one. But because it didn't do that, it resulted in this episode getting hit with all the backlash. Because without a proper conclusion, all of River's story looks messy and confusing in hindsight. And so this episode, which is the only one where River is almost entirely the focus, is the one that got targeted. All of the questions that should have been answered were put onto Let's Kill Hitler, because the actual episode whose job it was to answer those questions couldn't be bothered. I'm not saying that I'm surprised that that's the case. I'm just disappointed. I'm disappointed that an episode with so much good in it is constantly dragged through the mud over something that wasn't its responsibility. I'm disappointed that some of my favorite moments in the series are overlooked because they're in a quote, bad episode. I'm disappointed that my favorite season and my favorite character are both shit on top of all of that because Moffat decided to make his finale for River a complete nothing burger of an episode that you could skip the majority of and miss nothing.
Let's Kill Hitler is my favorite episode of season 6. It's probably one of my favorite episodes of New Who. And I think if we all just accepted that The Wedding of River Song was horrible and we stopped projecting its flaws onto everything else around it, maybe we could give this episode and season 6 the credit they've always deserved. But I don't know, man. Maybe it's just me. So, hey guys, I'm here and you're probably expecting me to say thanks for watching. I'll go back to being dead again now, but actually, I'm going to try and not do that. I've been wanting to actually post more this year as a sort of New Year's resolution to myself, and this is hopefully the start of that. So, yeah, hopefully we'll be seeing more of each other. Until then, I have a Tumblr where I post occasionally, and another Tumblr with a webcomic that I upload bi-weekly. I started a Patreon where I mostly post work doodles and concept art for my webcomic, and I'm starting commissions soon. So, all that shit is in the description if you're interested. If not, that's cool too, but I figured I should mention it. And until we meet again, interweb, I'm out.